You may recognize this plant because it's really made a mark on the houseplant world. This is formerly known as Sanseveria masoniana, but it's Dracaena masoniana, or whale fin snake plant, or whale fin Sanseveria. And this is the one that has a little bit more girth, it's a little bit more wide, and people love it. Actually, they were being sold at Home Depot for a cheap price, and probably much cheaper than what I got this one, but I've had this growing for about 3 years now in my bathroom, and it has started, it only started with two leaves, so I believe it was these two, and it's now started to put out some of these offsets. So it has three different offsets. So that's actually one way in order to be able to propagate this plant is actually by dividing it through the offsets, or you could actually take leaf cuttings. Now, I do realize when I actually got this that it had a bit of little brown scale, but these are pretty tough plants and I don't think scale is going to take it down. It might actually take out some of its vigor. But I realized that some of the little brown scale has come over to the newer plants, and it's just something, one of those things where you're gonna have to just constantly pick them off in order to be able to maintain the health of your plant. But if it's one thing that Sanseveria or Dracaena are susceptible to, it's actually scale, so that includes mealybug and the little brown scales that I'm referring to. But this plant is originally native to the Congo, and I am imagining that it's growing in somewhat drier conditions, and I've found that this grows very well in moderate light, and that is exactly what I'm giving it. It's not even in my northeast facing window. It's actually pulled back, and I do leave my bathroom light on sometimes in order to be able to get a little bit more light to some of my plants that are growing in the bathroom. But as you can see, it's actually putting out some offsets even in that kind of lighting condition. I'm sure if I'm giving it a little bit more direct light, or a little bit higher direct light, it would actually start putting out a little bit more offsets. And that's just one of the things that actually makes snake plants very easy to manage, is because they can work in a wide range of lighting conditions. My soil is a typical succulent soil, so it has a little bit of peat mix, but also some perlite, you know, in with this. And I think I'm probably just gonna leave the offsets in. I probably won't take them out because I can imagine this getting nice and filled up over several years, probably, over multiple years, because if this is what it's been growing over the last several years, then it needs like a lot more in order to be able to fill these up. As far as fertilizing goes, I mean, usually my snake plants, I'm fertilizing them once a year. And so because I'm fertilizing them once a year, I'll give them a well-balanced fertilizer. So maybe like a 10-10-10 or a 20-20-20. And then I'll like kind of cut that by half. So if it says a half a teaspoon per gallon of water, I'll do a quarter teaspoon of gallon per water. Or if I'm using an organic fertilizer, then I would recommend actually fertilizing it a little bit more frequently. But otherwise, they're very non-complaining plants and they are great to have around the house. This does kind of grow out a little bit more than your Dracaena trifasciata, which is ones that kind of grow a little bit more upright. So you do have to walk around it. You know, my bathroom's very small, so I kind of have to, sometimes I bump my leg on the edge of this, which is probably why you see some mechanical damage on the tip of this one. But as you could see with the new growth, it looks just perfectly fine.